My name is Neverson Mauvava, the president of Rotary Club of Bulawayo. As Rotary Club, we are involved in economy and community empowerment. This project is assisting young people with disabilities in transfer of skills and also in income generation.
It's a real pleasure to talk to you about the Duma stove. We've taken the tried and tested technology of the rocket stove and we've adapted it to the Zimbabwean environment. We've been able to develop the stove using recycled materials and that's enabled us to make it more affordable. What we did as well was we listened to the end user, the people cooking on the stoves, and we were told by them that they use as much wood to heat water as they do cooking. And so that's one of the things we took into consideration when we developed the stove, and we've enabled the stove to heat water, about 15 to 20 liters of water while they're cooking their normal food. And this enables them to have water for bathing the children and for washing dishes, and that's just free with the same amount of wood. We also believe that the stove uses about 20% of the wood that a normal open fire would use, and this is for many reasons. We've insulated the firebox, which enables the stove to cook with much greater efficiency. The firebox will get to a temperature of 300 to 500 degrees Celsius, enabling the wood to release a very flammable syn gas, which is then used in the cooking process as well. We've provided a pot shield around the cooking pot, and that enables the pot not only to heat from the bottom, but the sides while it's cooking. And this has greatly enhanced the efficiency of the cooking process. We've also provided a chimney on the pot so that it's creating an additional draw on the fire, which enables the fire to burn more efficiently and cleanly and enhances the cooking process.
In rural Africa, women are most vulnerable when they're out fetching water or fetching firewood. And we have endeavored to address one of these challenges. These stoves are having a huge impact in the lives of women. They're having to spend less time fetching firewood. They're using less wood when they're cooking, and cooking is taking a much shorter time.
One of the things we've done in developing the stove is look for ways to cut the cost of the stove, and we've been able to use discarded gas cylinders. We've taken these cylinders and we've made them as part of the stove. So this is upcycling, and it's really helped us to reduce the cost of the stove. And that's something we really appreciate and hold dear, because we are looking for ways to be environmentally conscious while developing these stoves. Another area that we really wanted to take advantage of while developing these stoves was to work with people with disabilities. And so we have currently four young men who are hearing impaired, and we're working with them, and they are the ones actually fabricating the stoves. They're doing the production from the beginning to the end, and we're actually currently teaching them and developing their skills as we build these stoves. And this has been very exciting for us. Our long-term goal for them is for them to become independent of us and to run their own fabrication businesses.
The project has helped the young apprentices to be able to be financially independent by earning a salary. Some of them have not been able to, say, open bank accounts by virtue of their disability, but we've been able to help them get bank accounts. Some now have cell phones and can communicate via WhatsApp.
It's not a normal kind of setup, but a more privileged setup that you express your love to them and they get to understand how you work when it comes to the metal industry.
Going forward, we are so excited as we believe that this project will bring positive social transformation and economic empowerment.